Hello friends, here in this video we will see the definition of lever and the types of levers. So I'll get started with it. Lever. It is defined as a machine member which can rotate about a fixed point, and that fixed point is called as fulcrum. So here I have written the definition of a lever, that it is defined as a machine member which can rotate about a fixed point or fulcrum. Next, it is used to lift heavy loads by the application of less or very less efforts. See here. So levers, they are used to lift heavy loads by applying comparatively less value or even very less value of efforts. So it is a mechanical device which is operated by us, means the effort which is used to drive the lever, that is provided by us. So here I'll mention that it is a mechanical device mostly operated by hand or foot. Next, lever consists of three main parts. Like, the most important part of a lever is called as fulcrum, then load arm and effort arm. So here I have given a brief introduction of levers. Next, I'll explain it with a diagram. Now here I am drawing this end which is called as the fulcrum. Now this end, it is called as the fulcrum, which is the fixed point, and this horizontal line which I have drawn, this indicates a lever. Now, as I have told, in case of lever, there are three important parts. One is called as fulcrum, other is called as load arm, and the next one is called as effort arm. So suppose at the end of this lever, I am placing a load. So the distance between fulcrum up to the center of this load, this would be called as load arm. And the length of load arm, I'll denote it by L1. Next, on the other side of the lever, here we would be applying the effort, because levers are mechanically operated, they need to be operated by some effort. So this effort we will apply, and I'll denote effort by P, and load would be denoted by W. So the distance between the fulcrum and the point of action of the effort, this would be called as the length of effort arm, which is, this is the effort arm denoted by L2. So now, from the diagram, it is very much understood that if we want to lift this load, we need to apply downward effort, and this lever, it will be rotating about this fulcrum, and it, when the effort moves it down, it will move up from the other side, and hence the load gets lifted. So this is a very simple example of lever. Now, if I can say that here, in case of this lever, I can draw this diagram in a more simplified manner, then here I will draw a line which indicates the lever. At the center, here we have the fulcrum. Now, since there are load and effort, because of that, what will happen? On one side, we have load. On the other side, we have effort. Distance from fulcrum to load arm, this is L1. Distance from fulcrum to effort arm, this is L2. So now, this is the more simplified diagram of a lever, and in this I'll say that therefore taking moments of all forces about fulcrum, if I take the moments here, so therefore if I am considering clockwise moment as positive, so it will be W into L1 minus P into L2 is equal to 0. I am writing this as 0 for the equilibrium condition of this lever. So therefore W into L1, I'll shift this P into L2 onto the other side. So hence load upon effort is equal to L2 by L1. Now this relation which I am getting of load upon effort, this is called as mechanical advantage. So I'll say that therefore mechanical advantage for a lever, that is equal to load upon effort. Now this equation, actually this is very important. It gives the relation between load and effort, and also the relation between their distances. Now mechanical advantage, if the value is more of mechanical advantage, it means either the load applied is more or the effort applied is less. Mechanical advantage also helps us to determine, to calculate the length of the lever, that is the length of effort arm as well as load arm, here I have indicated. Now, after this, once we have understood this, I can define or give types of levers according to the engineering applications. I'll say that types of levers, here we have three kinds of lever which are used in engineering. Those are called as first order levers, next second order levers, and at last third order levers. So here I have three different types of levers. Now let us see each of these types in detail. So I'll write down, therefore the explanation of levers are as follows. The first one is first order lever. Now, when we are talking about first order lever, here I'll draw the diagram for that so that it becomes easy to understand. In between, we have fulcrum. On one side, we have load. On the other side, we have effort. So now, here the load is acting and here we have effort applied. And opposite to them, we have RF, which is called as the reaction at the fulcrum. Now, since fulcrum is in between load and effort, such a kind of lever, it would be called as first order lever. So here, if the fulcrum is in between load and effort, then it is called as first order lever. So here is a condition which I have mentioned. For first order lever, fulcrum should be in between. Distance between the fulcrum to the load, that we know, it is denoted by L1. Distance between fulcrum and effort, that is L2. So this was regarding first order lever. Now I'll give some of the examples of first order lever. On to the next page. Examples of first order lever. Some of the examples are, the first one is hand pump. Second, punching press, hand wheel. Next, there is rocker arm. And then after hand pump, punching press, rocker arm, then we can say beam balance, that is also an example of first order lever. So here I have given the explanation. Now next, second order lever. Now in case of second order lever, here also I'll explain it with a diagram. F indicates the fulcrum. Now here we are applying the effort and this is the load, and here we get reaction at the fulcrum. Now, as it is clear, now fulcrum is on one side. Previously for first order lever, fulcrum was in between. Now distance between this fulcrum and load, this is denoted by L1. Distance between fulcrum and effort, this is denoted by L2. So now here we can see that the length of effort arm is more compared to the length of load arm. So this is the definition point, that in second order levers, the length of effort arm, that is L2, is greater than the length of load arm, which is L1. So if we are getting the length of effort arm greater than the load arm, it would be called as second order lever. I'll give the examples. Examples of second order lever. Here second order lever, they are, in that case we can say, the effort applied would be less because effort arm is greater. This point is important, and hence we will get maximum mechanical advantage. So the applications are, mostly it is used for dead weight safety valves. These deadweight safety valves are mostly used in case of boilers. So they operate on the condition of second order lever. Now the third one, which is third order lever, here also I'll explain it with a diagram. Fulcrum is on one side again. Now here I can show it with a diagram. As we know, distance between fulcrum and load, that is called as L1, distance between effort and fulcrum, this is called as L2. Here the length of load arm is more as compared to effort arm. So I'll define it. In this lever, the load arm is greater than the effort arm. It means that therefore your L1 will be greater than L2, so it is called as third order lever. The examples are, we can say tongs and the treadle of sewing machine. So these are the examples of third order type of lever. Here, since the load arm is greater, so to lift this load, huge amount of effort will be required because effort arm is less. Example are tongs and treadle of sewing machine. It means it is the treadle, the foot pedal, which is there in case of sewing machine which we operate. That is an example of third order lever. So in this video we have seen what is meant by lever, its explanation, and the types of levers.